There is no such thing as my mind and your mind. When you identify with the mind, you take it to be your individual mind, and then this mind, these thoughts overpower you. In the case of an enlightened person, there is no identification with the mind. There is only the total mind, the universal mind, the cosmic mind. The mind is always there, but he makes use of it as and when required. Like the changes in the nature, mind also flows in various changes, and all the time it is not fit for use. When the thought storm is passing by, you can just sit back detached and allow it to pass. And when it settles down, you can see if you have to use it. Our problem arises when we try to use it, when it is turbulent and we get bowled over. The mind is always there. It is just our identification that is in the root of our problems. And then we want to finish the mind and try to stop it, and we fail miserably. The more we fight with it, the stronger it gets. When we learn to be aware and know when to use and when not to, then it creates no hassles and we can be friends with it, and it becomes a beautiful instrument. Only man has been gifted with mind, and therefore it is only man that can work towards his betterment and fulfillment, transcending all limitations. It is often said that even animals and other beings are satisfied in their nature. True, but they have no means to transform themselves, to work on their development, as they have no mind. Moreover, this desire also comes in the mind only. So they are satisfied, but in a very limited way. It is the mind that gives you the status of a human, wherein you have the full range of possibilities, from being an animal to man to God, and that is your freedom. Your choices are innumerable. You live in a field of infinite possibilities.